Love is care, share, and joy.
选择关系就是有听人听教会的人。
Choose people who truly care about people and care about the church.
第三,
Third,
serve the Lord with trials. 以纪念来侍奉你的上帝。
Serve the Lord with trials.
保罗说：“我服侍上帝，凡事谦卑，目中流目屎，因为犹太人的庙会经历试炼。”
Paul said, I served the Lord with great humility and with tears, and in the midst of severe testing by the plots of my Jewish opponents. Serving the Lord is not something that's smooth sailing all the time. And because of the opposition of the Jews, Paul's service to the Lord was filled with great difficulties. But Paul regarded this kind of opposition as a kind of trial or testing. There is no one who serves God who will not encounter or experience difficulties. Sometimes difficulty may come from people, sometimes difficulty may come from things or issues. But there will surely be difficulties. There will surely be criticism. There will surely be attacks or oppositions. But when they start happening in your life, what do you do? Do you regard this as a kind of testing that God has brought into your life, or do you regard this as an opposition from your enemy? Sometimes whenever I needed to make a very important decision for the church, it may not necessarily be true that everyone will understand the decision I'm making. Perhaps some people may start criticizing and attacking me behind my back. Now, this is not an attack or opposition, but rather this is a testing from the Lord. You shouldn't be putting too much emphasis on how people will say, but rather what God is going to say about you. Because we're not serving man, but rather we are serving God. Let me give you a very important advice. Every one of us would got to take good care of our character and let God take care of our reputation. Sometimes we pay too much attention on our reputation. Whenever people say something, just one word, and then we jumped up immediately. We feel that our reputation is very important.
Yes, reputation 真重要.
Yes, reputation is important.
Let God to take care of your reputation.
But why don't we let God take care of our reputation?
Integrity, our character.
And rather, we need to take care of our own character and integrity. May the Lord help us. You must remember, because we are serving God.
Trial and testing.
And surely there will be a lot of trials and testings that come our way. Who do we choose to be? People who are going to be serving the Lord in the church. Choose people who knows how to keep silent even amidst attacks and oppositions. Don't choose people who keep saying, attacking behind people's backs. For this will slowly become gossiping. Slowly, it will become a kind of a faction. Choose people who are willing to swallow their difficulties for the Lord. Serve the Lord with trials. Number four.
Serve the Lord with boldness.
Serve the Lord with boldness. Serve the Lord with boldness and courage. Look at verse 20. You know that I have not hesitated to preach anything that would be helpful to you, but I've taught you publicly and from house to house. For your benefit, I dare to say anything. Look at verse 27. For I have not hesitated to proclaim to you the whole will of God. If it's from the will of God, then I will tell you. I will proclaim everything to you. What is Paul trying to say? Whether you want to hear it or not, as long as it is of benefit to you, and as long as it is from the will of God, then I will be bold enough to proclaim to you every single word. Church. Words that may be helpful to you may not necessarily be words that you would want to hear.
Isn't it?
Just like what? Good food may not necessarily be helpful to you.
Delicious.
They're delicious.
Lechon.
Like lechon.
Christmas 来了, lechon.
Well, Christmas is around the corner. Lechon.
Some roast beef.
Roast beef. There may not necessarily be of benefit to you.
But
if it's from God's will, then there will be nothing that I would hesitate to proclaim to you. There are many things that we may not necessarily like to listen to. For example,
tithing,
giving 10% of your income. Not everyone wants to listen to such kind of a message.
For example, wife submit to your husband.
Wife submit to your husband. Not every wife would want to listen to such kind of a message. Many years ago. And this is something that I found out later on. I was doing a premarital counseling with a young couple. I said to this lady,
wife, submit to your husband.
I said, the Bible tells us that wife, you must submit to your husband.
Husband, love
husband,
your wife.
You must love your wife.
And then I explained submission, love.
And then I explained the meaning of submission, I explained the meaning of love. And after we had our session, and here's something that I found out like later on. When the two persons left my office, the woman said to the husband,
Submission?
Submission? Why should we talk about submission? And I didn't know that. And if I knew that, then I would probably have told the two of them that you probably should postpone your wedding for a while.
Something
is wrong. Today, the two of them are already separated. And of course, I'm not saying that it's all the fault of the wife.
Something wrong.
But there's something wrong. No, not everyone likes to listen to such. Husbands,
love your wife.
Love your wife. Well, not every man would like to listen to
that. You're the leader of your family.
You're the leader of the family. You must be the one to teach your children and do your responsibility. And don't let your wife do that. Not every man wants to hear that. And Paul said that whenever it is something that's of benefit to you, I'm going to tell you every single word.
Obey your parents.
Men or children, like obey your parents.
Parents.
When your children are grown up,
let go and let God.
Then you must let go and let God. Let them go. You don't have to meddle in their business. But not every parent wants to listen to such kind of a message. If the message is of benefit to you, you may not necessarily like it. Yet Paul said, I will tell you every single word. Where did Paul's boldness come from? Because Paul understood that he wasn't serving man. He was serving God. Whatever God wants me to say, that is what I will say. But listen to this carefully. Boldness is not equivalent to being careless. There are a lot of people who are very bold in church, but they are very careless. Church is a place of spiritual authority.
Spiritual authority 人,
If a person doesn't know how to submit to spiritual authority, then he or she cannot be a leader of the church.
勇敢不代表随便,
Boldness doesn't mean you can be careless. We have to be bold in God's truth. You must be bold enough in submitting to the Lord's authority.
Serve the Lord with boldness.
We must serve the Lord with boldness.
Number five. Serve the Lord with faithfulness.
Serve the Lord with faithfulness. Be faithful in serving the Lord. Look at verses
23 and 24.
I only know that in every city the Holy Spirit warns me that prison and hardships are facing me. I know. I know, Paul said that when I go to Jerusalem, there will be a lot of hardships and even prison will be awaiting me.
But
however, I consider my life worth nothing to me. My only aim is to finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the good news of God's grace. Paul said, I know. I know that ahead of me are a lot of hardships and difficulties. Church, if you want to be a leader, do you know that there will be a lot of hardships, a lot of difficulties, a lot of criticisms ahead of you? If you are a leader in the church, you're not a boss of the church.
We are the servant leader.
But we are supposed to be servant leaders. When people are going to be criticizing you, people are going to be attacking you. Do you know that or not? If you don't know that, then you shouldn't be serving at all. Paul said, I know. Chinese was saying,
明知善有福,偏向福善行.
And this means that you know that there is a tiger up ahead, and yet you continue, you persist in moving forward. Where did Paul's courage come from? It comes from verse 24. Because I consider my life worth nothing to me. What is the most precious thing for me in my life? And that is to complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me.
What is the task of the Lord?
But what is the task of the Lord?
To testify to the good news of God's grace.
It is testifying to the good news of God's grace. Most important thing in my life is to testify to the good news of God's grace. Church, let me ask you a question. In your life, apart from your life being most important, what else is more important than your life? You know, this world is really a contradiction. Some people feel that money is more important. When you're young, you pour your heart into making money, into making lots of money. And then as a result of your pouring your heart into making money, you lose your health. And as a result, when you're old, you're very wealthy. And then you use your wealth to get back your health.
What are you doing?
This is a paradox. What is more important than life itself? It's not money. It's not fame. Because all of this will pass one day. Remember that we came into this world empty-handed, and we're going to be leaving this world empty-handed as well. And there is something that's more important than money. The task of the Lord. Because the task of the Lord is going to remain forever. Paul regarded the mission of the Lord as being more important than his own life. And he wasn't even afraid of death. And if a person isn't even afraid of death, there is nothing that's going to make this person afraid. And for Paul, 30 years of service to the Lord was just like 1 year to him. And when he was about to pass away, and he spoke these very famous words. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. And with these three sentences, if you turn this, you summarize this with two English words,
finish well.
Call this finish well.
Finish well.
Paul said, finish well. It's done. Done. It's finished.
Finish well.
Finish well.
换成汉文,
and if you translate this into Chinese,
是下汉文的,
three Chinese characters,
叫做保满界,
保满界, may the Lord help us. Let's not finish up, but you don't finish well. Many people believe in the Lord, and yet they don't finish well. There are a lot of people who serve the Lord, but they don't finish well. Started out as if they were very passionate for the Lord, loved the Lord a lot. But then, what was the result? It's got like the head of a tiger and a paper tail. So, may the Lord help us. And amongst the co-workers that I serve together, after I've been working with them for quite some time, and if I discovered that my co-worker isn't being responsible, I would usually be the person to screen them out, because this person is being irresponsible. This Chinese have saying that you know, you start out well but you don't finish well. And the Chinese are saying that we must be faithful unto the end.
Serve the Lord with faithfulness.
We must serve the Lord with faithfulness. Number six.
Serve the Lord with caution.
Serve the Lord with caution. Serve the Lord with a very cautious spirit. Look at verses 28 and 29. Keep watch over yourselves and all the flock of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers. Be shepherds of the church of God, which he bought with his own blood. I know that after I leave, savage wolves will come in among you and will not spare the flock. And Paul spoke to the church, the elders of the church in Ephesus, something very important. Says, once I leave this church, I know. I know that wolves will be coming in. They may look like sheep on the outside, but they are actually wolves on the inside. They are false prophets, false preachers, false pastors. They don't really love the flock. That's why you need to be very cautious.
It is a godly leadership.
And because you are the leaders of the church, you need to oversee and take care of the flock that God has entrusted to you.
How?
How? You need to keep watch over yourself and the Lord's flock. Why do you need to be careful for your own sake? Because leaders are usually the targets of the attacks of the people and attacks of Satan. And the Chinese says it very well.
领袖,
what is a 领袖 or leader?
这个叫做领,
this part is called
这个叫做兽,
and this is show.
These two places.
So these two are called 领袖 in Chinese. which means leaders. These two portions of a shirt is the places where it gets dirty the most. And leaders are people who are looked up to. But they are people who are being criticized the most. People who are being attacked the most. So you've got to be careful for yourself. If you fall, how many people will you drag down with you?
Group leaders.
Small group leaders. If you fail, well, think about it. How will your small group members continue? For your own sake and for the sake of your flock, you must be careful. Whenever I learned that people in my small groups or the small groups in the church love one another, I am always very happy. As a leader, you are like a shepherd. You've got to look after and take care of your own sheep. Whenever I hear of small group leaders in the church taking good care of their small group members, you know, the happiness that I feel is something that you wouldn't expect. One time I was in the office. There was a person who called me up. He informed me of something. That a small group member is about to undergo the operation. And it was quite a serious illness. And she was a lady who was still very young. She still had a few small children. Actually, I was quite busy in the office during that time. But then I felt in my heart, well, I should go and visit her. So I had to leave my work. And I drove to the hospital. And when I was about to enter the room, I was hearing a lot of voices inside the room. So I slowly opened the door. And I saw a lot of people inside the room. And I realized that it was the members of our small groups, the small group leaders and the leader and his members were there. And I was so happy. You wouldn't imagine. And I said to myself, I shouldn't be here. There was no need for me to go there. But then I waited for them to finish their prayer. And then they turned around and said, oh, pastor is here. So I spoke with them again.
After 15 minutes,
I told them, well, let's pray again. Closing prayer, I said. After we prayed, I left. And I was driving my way back. You know, the joy that I felt is something that couldn't indescribable. And if the small group leaders in the church, every one of them is like that, this is what the church is all about. This is a church. But whenever I hear of people who are taking advantage of people in the small groups, I really am very unhappy. Many times there was an instance.
Take advantage and take advantage and take advantage again and again and again.
There was a person who was taking advantage again and again of other people. One time I just came home from Hong Kong. I just walked into my office and just sat down on my chair, and then the phone rang.
The same complaint.
And this person was still cheating people again. And then I warned her a number of times already. And in this case, in this instant, I personally called her up. I said, sister so-and-so, the church of God welcomes you. But when you come to church, you come here to worship. You don't come here to cheat others and take advantage of others. I hope that you repent. If you don't repent, this place is not a place where you should be coming. And she was so angry. She was so angry at me. And then she stopped coming. And then she said a lot of bad things. I will never ever be afraid of people saying bad things about me. Because I believe in this word. We've got to take care of our own character, and God is going to be the one who takes care of our reputation. You don't have to defend yourselves all the time. Let God be the one to take vengeance on your behalf. Church, we serve God, and we need to serve God very cautiously. We must serve the Lord with caution. Number seven,
serve the Lord with a clear conscience.
We must serve the Lord with a clear conscience. We must serve the Lord with a clear conscience. Paul said, I have not coveted anyone's silver or gold or clothing.
First Timothy 6:5.
And then if you refer to 1 Timothy 6:5, Paul said, there are some people who think that godliness is a means to financial gain. Two kinds of people serving God. There are some people who serve the Lord with a clear conscience. But there are some people who serve the Lord thinking that godliness is a means to financial gain. So who do you choose to be, deacons? Of course, you choose the first one. There are a lot of temptations in this world. And here it talks about the temptation of money. Perhaps when you serve God, there will be opportunities wherein money, a lot of money, are going to pass through your hands. Especially if you are the pastor. A pastor whom people highly respect. A pastor whom people trust. A lot of money may pass through your hands. This is what we call temptation. May the Lord help us. One time, I went to another church to preach. And there was this particular person who wanted to donate a certain sum of money to CBCP. 500,000 pesos. Half a million pesos.
Manager check.
It was a manager's check. And then he even instructed me, Pastor, don't ever let anyone know. I said, no problem. Well, no one knows anyways. You don't know, nobody knows, so I can just keep it in my pocket, right? This is what we call temptation. One time I went to St. Luke's to visit a patient. Suddenly, when my car was about to arrive, suddenly, a person who motioned me to stop. Well, initially I was scared. I thought, is this a kidnapping or what? Well, it was actually a brother from the church. Next time when you want to give your money, don't do this. It'll scare me. He jumped out from the car. Gave a brown envelope to me. 200,000 pesos cash. Says, Pastor, I just saw you passing by. So here's the money that I want to give to the church. May God help us. Money is a very serious temptation. But what did Paul say? I serve the Lord with a clear conscience. I'm not serving the Lord because of financial gain. I'm not serving the Lord because of any other motive. One time, me and my wife, together with our three children, were having a conversation at home. Suddenly, one of my child says, my son says that in the future, he plans to start a lot of stores. So, Mom, you take care of this store. I said, what about me? I want to manage one of the stores also. My son says, no, you can't. I asked why. You're a pastor. You're not supposed to be managing a business. Praise God. He knows that as a pastor, I'm not supposed to be managing a business. Children know. But a lot of people who serve the Lord don't know that. May the Lord help us. We must have a very clear conscience. And then I remember a person by the name of Samuel. Samuel served the Lord, and when he was old in age, he called all the people to him. And in public, he spoke to the people. He said, I am old and gray, and my sons are here with you. I have been your leader from my youth until this day. Here I stand, testify against me in the presence of the Lord and his anointed. Whose ox have I taken? Whose donkey have I taken? Whom have I cheated? Whom have I oppressed? From whose hand have I accepted a bribe to make me shut my eyes? If I have done any of these things, I will make it right. Publicly, he declared, have I cheated you of anything? Have I robbed any of you? Have I stolen from any of you? And if I have, then I'm going to make it right. I'll pay back. How did they respond? The people replied, you have not cheated or oppressed us. You have not taken anything from anyone's hand. He served the Lord for more than 50 years.
You have not cheated or oppressed us. You have not taken anything from anyone's hand. Serve the Lord with clear conscience.
This is what it means to serve the Lord with a clear conscience. May God help us. I hope that at the end of our service to the Lord, you dare declare this publicly that I have not cheated any one of you. This is what we call example.
Serve the Lord.
Serve the Lord
with clear conscience.
With the clear conscience.
The last one.
You're
going to serve the Lord with sacrifice.
Serve the Lord with sacrifice. Serve the Lord with a spirit of sacrifice. Look at verse 34. You yourselves know that these hands of mine have supplied my own needs and the needs of my companions. His hands of mine supplied my own needs as well as the needs of others. In everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak. Remember the words of the Lord Jesus himself who said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Why did Paul say this or do this?
In everything I did, I showed you that by the kind of hard work, you must help the weak.
This is an intentional thing that Paul did in order to set an example for the people to follow. And then Paul concluded with the words of the Lord Jesus. It is more blessed to give than to receive, he said. May the Lord help us. People who serve the Lord. You must have a sacrificial spirit, a sacrificial attitude. If a person is always looking after his own right, then this person shouldn't be serving the Lord. I'm sorry that I needed to say something today. People who serve the Lord in the church, you shouldn't feel that you are so great. I always hear of people saying that I serve the Lord full time.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I want to open this in order for you to understand. This is actually a lie. What does it mean to serve the Lord full time? You feel that you are greater, you're more special than others. Others are not full time. I am full time.
No. Let me explain to you.
Let me explain this to you. This person, he's not serving the Lord full time. He's got his own family, his own work, his own business, and he has to go and work every day after working. He has to spend his time in serving the Lord in the church. And he doesn't get paid for it.
我这个叫做全时间侍奉上帝啦。
And me, who served the Lord full time.
我office hour在教会最近。
I work in the church during office hours.
然后呢?
After that,
我跟人家说我是全时间侍奉上帝啦。
And then I tell people that I'm serving the Lord full time.
我跟读书教会的圣经。
And then I get paid by the church.
我无限伟大。
I am not that great after all.
求主帮助人。
So may the Lord help us. What am I trying to say? A person who serves the Lord. Serves the Lord with a sacrificial attitude. You shouldn't always be very calculating. A person who's very
calculating.
Then you do not deserve to be serving the Lord in the church. Imagine this. People are not people don't get paid.
How about us?
How about us? Since we are getting paid for our work. Then all the more, we do not deserve to say that I'm serving the Lord full time. Every person, we are all serving the Lord full time. And although we are in different positions or status, every person cannot compare himself with others. Because we are eventually accountable to God, not to man. With such kind of a spirit, let us serve the Lord. It is more blessed to give than to receive. I've been serving the Lord for 26 years now. And I have deeply understood this word. That if I do more, I give more, then God's grace come upon my life even more. It is indeed even more blessed to give than to receive. This is the kind of attitude and spirit that we need to have in serving the Lord. So that is why the Bible says, whoever has will be given more, and whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. Let us not be afraid. We just need to continue to work on. The Lord will never shortchange anyone. And after Paul spoke these words with the church, not only did Paul hear his words, but Paul saw, rather the church saw. And they saw how this minister Paul served the Lord. And they were deeply moved. And the Bible tells us that after Paul spoke, had finished speaking, they all knelt down together and prayed. Look at verse 37. All the people wept as they embraced Paul and kissed him. This is what we call example. This is life on life discipleship. So may God help us. Today is the day for us to elect our new set of deacons. You need to know who you should be choosing to be the new deacons. May the Lord help you.
Take a minute for meditation.